Hello everybody, it's Jamie and I'm back from vacation, and today we have a new kind of series. It's called The Dutch on Board the RMS Titanic. Now, firstly, I didn't know that there were Dutch aboard the Titanic. So I was quite surprised, but then again, there were all nationalities aboard this vessel. Now, what I plan to do with this kind of series is tell the story of some of these Dutch and Flemish passengers aboard the Titanic. And I got it from a book that is actually called Titanic and it's Dutch and Flemish passengers. Sadly, for the English among us, it's only in Dutch. But yeah, let's begin with this first video. Now, the passenger that we'll be taking a look at was called Johan George Roechlin. Now, the roots of this family are from South Germany, but they would later move to Holland. Now, the father of Johan was Sir Otto Roechlin, and he was a successful wine merchant. But he was also one of the co-founders of the famous Dutch shipping company, the Holland America Line. Now, Johan would follow his father in his footsteps, and he would mainly work at the main building of the Holland America Line in Rotterdam. Now, the young Johan would marry his wife Agave Eelink in 1905. Later in 1906, 1 year after his wedding and the year that his first son was born, Johan was made director of the Holland America Line main building in Rotterdam. Now, because the Holland America Line was quite a famous company, they were part of the International Mercantile Maritime Company, also known as IMM. One funny fact is that he also became in contact with the White Star Line director, none other than J. Bruce Ismay, who had plans to make a shipping lane from Antwerp and Rotterdam, which would go to New York following the West Coast. And now we shall move on to the Titanic, of course. Now, when the date of the maiden voyage of the Titanic was known in 1912, Johan's father, he had a ticket, but personally he didn't want to go, so he gifted the ticket to Johan, of course not knowing what tragedy would follow up. So Ismay knew that Johan would be on board the Titanic, and he even wrote a personal letter in which he would say, like, "Don't worry, I will get you a comfortable cabin. Don't worry about it, I will handle it." So you can see how the relation was between them two, like how they worked together, that he even wrote a personal letter to him. So for me, that's quite interesting. Now, on Monday evening, 8 April 1912, he kissed his wife and children goodbye. 2 days later, now on board the Titanic, he wrote a letter home saying that he was so happy that they could spend that Monday evening together in peace and quiet. So Johan, he was quite a family man, so later in this video you shall also notice that. Now, on 10 April 1912, he boarded the Titanic. He wrote how he got a comfortable and amazing cabin aboard the liner, and that all was well. He also saw the small incident with the SS New York when she was about to cast off, writing home how it could have been an immense tragedy if a collision would have occurred. Now, Johan would go to New York with the Titanic, so he also passed Cherbourg. Now, what Johan mainly did on board was writing home. Now, this shows to me how he was a family man and how he missed them. Now, of course, he wanted his family to be there with him, so he can imagine then how he missed him. Now, the last letter that Johan would write home would be on 14 April 1912, in the early evening. Now, we all know what happened next. The Titanic would hit an iceberg later that evening and sink. Now, in the office of the Holland-America line in New York, the director there was Sir Adrian. Now, when he heard that the Titanic had sank, he went to see if Johan had survived. Now, Adrian was sure that Johan was safe on the Carpathia. Sadly, later, the name of Johan would be on the list of those who died that night. The Holland-America line, after the sinking, would honor Johan with putting their flags out halfway for a week. Now, his family was on a quest to know what happened that night, as everybody would want to know that. And they got help from the survivor Lawrence Beasley. On 20 June 1914. He wrote a letter to Johan's family with all the answers that he could give. Now, the answers that, or the questions that Johan's family asked him was like, did you know my husband? Did you talk with him? Did you see him when the ship was sinking? What was he doing? And now this is what he had to say. On that fateful night, he saw that Johan was fully clothed and he had his coat on his arm. Like the others, he was seen on the A deck where the lifeboats were being launched. Now, personally, I can't imagine what Johan was thinking at that time. I mean, he was surely thinking like, am I ever gonna see my family again? Also, because of course the rules of women and children first. He was surely thinking about that, and that is quite sad that he was there all alone. So I can't imagine what he was thinking on that cold deck. So sadly, there isn't much else on to what happened on that fateful night with him, but we sadly know that he didn't survive. And that is the end of the first episode of Dutch Passengers and Flemish on the Titanic. Now, although this video, it doesn't have a happy ending, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you got to learn a new aspect about the vessel sinking. And I plan to do more of these videos with Dutch passengers to shed a little bit light on the story and the sinking. But if you have friends who like ocean liners or ships, please show them my channel. We are trying to reach the 400 subs and I know we can do it together. And also a big thank you to the people who already have subscribed. Now, also please leave in the comments what you thought of this video, because your comments really help me a lot on how to improve. Now, with that out of the way, guys, I wish you a good night or day wherever you are, and we will see each other on the next video. Goodbye.